Hi. Downstream processing is one of the important factors in a bioprocess industry. It is a process of isolation, separation, and purification of products produced in the industry. Most of the topics under the downstream processing will be covered as seminars, so I'll be discussing only the basic introduction of downstream processing in this video. Downstream processing is very important in bioprocess industry. It can cause 15 to 70% of production cost. Sometimes it is very high. And most of the cases, our product is produced by the microorganism in very less quantities. After fermentation, we will get a broth. This broth is consisting of different things, not only our product. Along with our product, there will be microorganisms will be there. The live and dead microorganisms will be there after the fermentation. Then cell fragments will be there. After the death of microorganism, it will be fragmented, so its DNA will be released, the protein will be released, and every internal components, lipids, carbohydrates, everything will be released into the medium. So it will have the fragment, cell fragments, and other metabolites produced by the microorganism. If you are looking for an antibiotic, along with this antibiotic, the microorganism is producing primary metabolites, secondary metabolites, some other like enzymes. So things that, like that will be there in the medium. And there will be unused media components. Even if you are producing carbon and nitrogen source, microorganism won't use everything in food. So unused media components will be there in the medium. So after the fermentation, we are getting our product in this huge mixture of many things. Some of the metabolites will be very small in quantity, like maybe in 1% of the volume. Sometimes it will be 30% or 40% of the media. So in downstream processing, we are trying to isolate our product from other components. For that, we are using different downstream strategies, and the type of downstream processing we are using in a particular process is depending on several other factors. First one is locational product, whether it is an intercellular product or an extracellular product. Strategies for downstream processing vary depending on the location of the product. Intercellular product, we need to isolate the microorganism first, then we need to break open the microorganism, then isolate the product. If an extracellular product is produced, one will filter off the microorganism and will take the medium and isolate the product. So, location of the product is important. Concentration, if the product is seen in high concentration, purification is easy. But if it is seen in very low concentration, like 0.1% of the whole medium, it will become difficult. Physical and chemical properties of the product. All separation and purification is done using the difference in physical and chemical properties. So some components are easy to separate, but in some other medium, after the fermentation, we will be getting many similar products. So if you want to isolate only one of them, it will become more difficult. Intended use of the product. So if you are using the product as an agricultural feed or using as a human food, or some of the products will be used as a pharmaceuticals. So if you are using it as a pharmaceutical, it should have highest possible purity. But if you are using it as a fertilizer, you know, don't need that much purity. So depending on the intended use, the purity requirement will vary. So depending on the purity requirement, downstream processing will be vary. Biohazard of the product. If the product is biohazardous, the strategy should be designed so that it won't be harmful for anyone. Impurities. If the microorganism, the fermentation leads to impurities or byproducts, it will become difficult for separation. Market value. So whole downstream processing is depending on the market value. If the market value is less, we cannot invest so much in the downstream processing. So we will use only basic equipments and basic techniques to reduce the cost. So these all things affect the way we isolate and purify the product. So in most of the fermentation, the first step is separation of solid particles and media. Then we'll go for fractionation and purification. This is the basic steps in a typical fermentation media downstream processing. So after the fermentation, we'll get a fermentation broth, and there is a step of removal of solids. If our product is intracellular, we will remove the solids, throw off the microorganisms and other solids, then take the supernatant or the liquid portion and go for the isolation. If our product is an intercellular product, we'll separate the solids, throw off the liquid part, And the solid part, we do a cell destruction to break open the cell. Once the cell is open, we use that extract for the isolation. So in the isolation, we have a primary isolation of the product, then go for the purification, then finishing of the product. So in this way, the fermentation is happening, the downstream processing is happening. So the strategies for intercellular and extracellular product is here. So I'm giving an example of a downstream processing of penicillin, which is very famous. So after the penicillin fermentation, first step is to harvest the broth from the fermenter. We'll get the broth, then we'll chill it. The temperature need to become 5 to 10 degree. Okay. Second step is cooling the meat broth, then go for a filtration. The penicillin is an extracellular product, so we don't need the mycelium there. So we'll filter off the penicillium, chrysogenum, mycelium using a rotary vacuum filter. So using a rotary vacuum filter, we will filter the medium and we will take the liquid part, and the solid penicillin chrysogenum part will be discarded. In this filtrate, after the filtration, we will get the filtrate. Next step is to acidify the filtrate. So the using hydrogen sulfuric acid, we do the acidification to make the pH 2 to 2.5. Okay. After acidification, there will be a liquid extraction. Penicillin is extracted to butyl acetate. Though the acidified penicillin is more soluble in butyl acetate, so in a countercurrent extraction process, the penicillin in the aqueous medium is extracted to butyl acetate. In the next step, the butyl acetate is again extracted. The penicillin is soluble in butyl acetate because of the low pH. So in the next step, what we do, we extract it in an aqueous buffer with a pH of 7. If the pH is increased to 7, the penicillin is no more miscible in the butyl acetate, it will be miscible in the aqueous solution. So in the next step, the penicillin from the butyl acetate is extracted to the aqueous medium, aqueous buffer, using the countercurrent extractor. And in the seventh step, we actually repeat the process once again. Once again, we acidify the medium, then extract into butyl acetate, then extract it into the buffer. Okay, acidify, extraction to butyl acetate, again pH will, we make the pH to 7, then extract to the aqueous medium. So that's what the seventh step is, repeating step 4 to 6, that's seventh step. Then once the two extraction steps is over, potassium acetate is added to the medium. Once we add the potassium acetate, penicillin become crystallized as the potassium salt. The crystallization is done using potassium acetate. By adding the potassium acetate, penicillin is getting crystallized. The crystals are recovered and these crystals are used for further processing. So this is the downstream processing of penicillin. In this way, different products can be separated. So in summary, we get the broth, chill, then filter out the penicillin chrysogenum mycelium. To the filtrate, we adjust the pH into acidic range, extraction to butyl acetate, then adjust the pH to 7 and extraction into aqueous buffer, then repeat the acidification, extraction to butyl acetate and extraction to aqueous buffer again, then potassium acetate is added to crystallize the penicillin, and after crystallization, crystals will be recovered and which is used for the further processing of the penicillin sap. So in downstream processing, we are using different techniques, and each of these techniques will be addressed in separate seminars. So thank you so much, and this is the end of the sixth unit of bioprocess technology.